Imagine if the Wisconsin Badgers played for a coach like Mike Budenholzer. He'd be fired. What's poppin', y'all? It's your man, Clopboy Bales, here with another analysis on the Bucks. We dropped game one. Unfortunately, as I thought what was going to happen, we were going to drop game one. I don't know if I said in my last video, but I said Atlanta was going to win game one because they did it in New York and they did it in Philly. And I was thinking Trae Young was just going to be too much, and I was correct. And it wasn't really just Trae Young. Everybody contributed exactly like I thought it was going to be. Trae Young is nearly unguardable. Now, yeah, we did it to Kevin Durant, and we somehow were able to come back and win the series. Yes, we were down 2-0, and yes, we were able to come back. But this is different. We lost a home game. That's a start off, and that's very dangerous to even, like, think about. You know, there's a lot to go on, and there's a lot of people to blame for this loss, but the thing was, no one showed up when it really mattered. Giannis and Holiday were the only people really doing anything, and that obviously was a big reason why they dropped this game. I mean, you get Giannis going 14 out of 25 from the field, 12 rebounds, 9 assists, almost a triple-double, 34 points. Holiday goes 14 out of 25, 5 out of 12 from 3, 4 rebounds, 10 assists, and 35 points. Middleton would have 15, Portis would have 11 coming off the bench. Please play him more. I have no idea what they're doing. And no one else seemed to really matter. Connaughton just was looking awful. He airballed a bunch of threes and basically costed us this game because he airballed a three, and I don't know why he would be taking. If you want to get the lead here, the ball goes to the dominant player who's being dominant, not Connaughton, who hasn't even hit a shot the entire game. You wanted to get to someone who's going hot. So that made no sense to me. Middleton obviously was another reason why they lost this game. He was 0-9 from downtown. If he at least hit a couple of those shots, I think, you know, we would have won the game probably. You know, he was missing a lot of shots when he really should have been making it. It just wasn't really his game. I mean, he still happened to score 15 points, but, I mean, I feel like we're going to need a lot more from Holiday if that's the case. You know, and we saw some other guys getting some minutes, but it just, I don't know what, by Bud seems to just never want to play people. I don't get it. Everybody on Atlanta seemed to really fit in. 17 out of 34 for Trae Young, 4 out of 13 for Deep, 7 rebounds and 11 assists, 48 points. Clint Capella had 12 points, 19 rebounds, of course, including the game ceiling. Trae Young missed the layup, and then, of course, he gets the putback, and I'm like, oh, great. Well, that's stupid. It's just, when Trae Young misses something, his teammates are there to help him. We had no one was on the offensive boards at all. There was no defense. And when no one could really, and when I saw Atlanta shooting, I was literally looking like, they're lucky to be missing these shots because these shots should be going in. I'm like, it's crazy. John Collins, also 23 points, 15 rebounds. Him and, obviously, Trae Young was Trae Young, but the reason why they dominated was because of Collins and Capella underneath. We were so focused on trying to stop Trae Young, even though he still dropped 48 points, that Collins and Capella just looked dominant. And that was obviously something that was bad. Because they kept getting their offensive boards. Everybody kept getting the offensive boards. Lopez was gassed. He couldn't do anything. And, you know, there was a lot of calls maybe on the Bucks that weren't the right calls. But, I don't know. It just did not seem right. You were up by 7 at some point. So you're thinking, oh, maybe you could take away this game. But no, they just kind of like didn't want to keep going with it. It's just their problem. Games 2 is on Friday. I'm actually going to the game. Yeah, I haven't been to a Bucks game in a very long time. So I'm hoping they actually win this one because they need this one more than ever. Overall, I can't express myself, you know. They literally gave this one to Atlanta. If no one wants to show up and play in these playoffs, Atlanta's going to win the series. I said this so many times. I don't care if Giannis is driving the basket and making dunks. I don't care if Holiday is throwing up assists and doing a playmaker. I don't care if PJ Tucker's playing defense. Lock on big dog defense. This Atlanta team is nowhere near the Nets team. I even said the Atlanta team is even better than the Nets team in some areas. Areas where it comes to shooting. I don't care how good Kevin Durant and James Harden are. This team is all around shooters, and that's something we stress with. You're 29th in the league in three-point defense. That's terrible. That's terrible. And they have obviously one of the best three-point defensive teams. So obviously that's a big deal. So obviously if the Bucks want to really get a win here, they have to start knocking down the shots when it really matters. Because if you give Atlanta any opportunities, they'll run it in your face, and they'll Trae Young will run it in. He'll get if he's open around for a three, he'll shoot a three. If he's double teamed outside the box, he'll pass it to a wide open teammate for three. If he drives, he'll lob it up for a floater. And then if he's double teamed when they arrive, he lobs it up for an alley-oop. He's unstoppable. That's why I said he's the best player in these playoffs, not Kevin Durant, because he led them. Atlanta was the fourth seed. No one expected them to get this far. And everyone's like, oh, Milwaukee should easily destroy him. I never said that. I said Bucks in seven because I know how good this Atlanta team is. I know. So, of course, Bucks need to rebound and get this. They don't win this game. They're not winning this series. I'm just saying that. Okay? So, anyways, it's your man, Club Boy Bales. Stay tuned for more updates. See you next time. Go Bucks. Let's get this next win.